Hey, Egan, this is Jordan Taylor. 10.
This week on Egan AM,
10 and under,
twins,
all the sports.
Live from the ITC, this is Egan AM.
Good morning, and welcome to this week's edition of Egan AM. I'm Peter Bosch.
And I'm Alana Stengel. Intramural basketball signups are closing in a week, so if you're thirsty for some competition, contact Coach Jordan or Graham for more information.
Also, money for student government t-shirts are due tomorrow and will cost $13.
Anyone interested in purchasing a letter jacket? A rep will be in all lunches today for fittings.
As the holiday season approaches, there is a multitude of inexpensive and even free activities to do. We followed Brett Nierengarten on a date to downtown Minneapolis for this segment of 10 and Under.
Contrary to popular belief, a date downtown doesn't have to break your bank. There are plenty of places to go, things to do, and sights to see in the Twin Cities. The Holidays Parade runs Thursday through Sunday, from the day after Thanksgiving all the way up to the middle of December. What started as a way to attract customers for businesses downtown has now become a sparkling spectacle that dazzles thousands of Minnesotans on the Nicollet Mall Strip each year. The parade runs from 6:30 to 8 every evening. Marching bands of nearby high schools and colleges, including Minneapolis Edison, McAllister, and Hamlin, use percussion in a series of light-up costumes to provide a unique take on holiday favorites. Floats and figures featuring favorite athletes, spooky creatures, and costumes that literally brighten up the night in Minnesota's largest city proves that there is something for all in the 20th year of the Holidazzle. The parade stretches over a 12-block span in Minneapolis, and the beautiful scene of a Christmas downtown accompanied with the parade makes the Holidazzle a fun, romantic, and of course, free way to enjoy. After watching the Holidazzle's famous finale, the Santa Fold, you can take the short walk down Nicollet to their flagship store, Macy's, where their 8th floor Santa Land gives people of all ages a chance to see a day in the life of an elf. The music, color, and Christmas spirit is sure to make your date smile. Macy's Santa Land uses wondrous displays that makes one think that somebody picked up the North Pole and put it in a box and brought it to the Twin City. And for a few moments, you relive your childhood memories and believe, just maybe, the man in the red suit might be real. You can also relive the days of your youth by visiting Santa Claus. By the time it's all over, you'll leave downtown with a smile, a date, and less than $10 out of your pocket. I'm Brett Nierengarten, Egan, AM.
Peter, we should go out sometime.
Well, I do know a few dollar menus. It'll be my treat.
The weather outside may be frightful, but the holiday glow around the metro is delightful.
Some houses in Egan have gone all out, really brightening up the city.
If you head over to Bloomington, you'll see a plethora of Christmas cheer, with lights strung from every branch and even a candy trunk or two.
And be sure to make the trek out to Bald Eagle Point in White Bear Lake. You'll be in for a treat. This small neighborhood has covered almost every piece of property with the brightest and most exciting lights in Minnesota. You might even find Santa Claus hanging out there.
A great job to the camera crew searching for all those lights.
Sounds like another idea for an inexpensive date. McDonald's and lights, I like it.
If you're new to EHS, you've probably been seeing double, literally. Twins are roaming the halls everywhere, so we sent out Luke Moe to get the scoop on what it's like to be a twin.
What's up, Egan? Do you know that we have over 30 pairs of twins here at EHS? Now, I'm not talking about your MLB baseball team, but rather someone with the same birthday. I set out to find out exactly what it's like to be a twin. So, like, how long have you been twins?
Since the womb.
17 years.
Plus 9 months.
Forever.
Yeah.
Forever. Do you have your own language?
Yeah, a little bit. Would you like to hear some?
Yeah. So do you guys like each other?
No. Sometimes.
Yep, very much.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say yes.
It has ups and downs.
You have to share everything.
No, you don't.
If I want a new shirt, Stephanie has to get a new shirt.
No, you just get it and I wear it.
Okay, no. Best friends, really.
Your best friend?
Yeah, definitely best friend.
We just like each other a lot.
So are you guys identical or fraternal?
Look at us.
Yeah. Fraternal. Yeah. Do you ever do any weird stuff?
Oh, yeah.
Like what? Do you guys ever switch places?
No, we haven't actually.
No, we don't.
No, we don't really look alike, so.
So which one of you gets more girls? Who's better looking? You have the same birthday.
I'd say so.
I think so.
Do you have any like weird telepathy moments?
We finish each other's sentences.
Yeah, sometimes. Like in the morning when we're getting ready for school,
we'll walk out with like the same outfit on at the same time.
It's weird.
Yes.
We say the same thing at the same time sometimes.
Yep. Wow. That's weird. After talking to a few sets of twins, I found out that it's entertaining, but also a burden sometimes. If you don't have a twin yet, the holidays are coming up. So ask your parents for one for Christmas. Reporting for Egan AM, I'm Luke Moe.
Peter, someone told me that we look like twins.
I think it must be our sweaters.
Or our good looks.
That too.
All NAHS members, there's a meeting after school today in the art room.
Make sure to bring $10 for the potluck.
Winter break is rolling in fast and creating much excitement about shopping and, of course, presents.
If you're still struggling to find out what to buy for that special someone, here are the top 10 holiday gifts of 2011.
At number 10, we have an Xbox 360 Kinect.
Number 9 is a 3D TV.
Number 8 is the Apple iPad 2.
Rolling in at number 7 is an espresso machine for those difficult mornings.
Number 6 is sports and concert tickets.
Number 5 is a fantastic gift for dads, golf clubs.
In spot number 4, clothing for any gender.
In third, we have a foot massager.
Runner-up is something cute and cuddly, pets.
And the top holiday gift for the year 2011 is an Amazon Kindle.
What are you getting me for Christmas?
Depends. Are you a cat or a dog person?
Definitely a dog person. Even though we are entering into the depths of winter, you should start planning ahead for next summer and consider the Summer Science Institute.
This activity is a great experience for all. We talked to Mr. Coalminen for more information on what the SSI experience entails.
SSI is Summer Science Institute. It's a summer program where we take about 45 kids, 5 TAs, and 5 teachers, and we head up to the Lake of the Woods for a 10-day wilderness experience. I would say out of most kids that go, the majority of them come back and say it was one of the better experiences they had in high school. So, you know, probably 95, 98% of the kids will come back and tell you they had a really good time.
In addition, participants also receive a science credit for attending.
The winter sports teams are definitely on the move.
Let's send it over to Taylor with a WCR.
Take it away, T-Budge.
What's up, Wildcat fans? We know it still looks a lot like fall outside with all this grass. Some might say it's because our athletes are playing so hot they're keeping the snow away. Let's first start off with boys hockey, who traveled to the Dakota Ice Center last Saturday to take on the Lakeville South Cougars. Even though the Wildcats were down 2-0 at the end of the first period and had a total of 4 penalties in the game, they played hard and came back to win 4-3. Among the scorers for the Wildcats were junior Will Peterson, along with seniors Cody Mason, Will Merchant, and Michael Zajac, which brings him to 9 points on the year. Freshman goalie Andrew Lindgren got to play his first varsity game of the season and impressed us all by stopping 10 of the 13 shots he saw. Egan also had an astonishing 38 shots on goal compared to Lakeville's 13. The 2-1 Cats will be skating at home tonight as they take on the 2-1 Lakeville North Panthers. Then the guys will play Rosemont on Saturday at home as well. They should be good games, so make sure you take the short drive out to cheer on our boys of winter. The girls' hockey team is ready to bounce back after a tough loss on Saturday versus Lakeville South 6-0. It was a battle of the Darwitzes as Coach Scott Darwitz led the way for the Wildcats, and his daughter, former Egan graduate and Olympic hockey team member Natalie Darwitz, coached the Cougars. The ladies hit the rink again on Tuesday night, beating the Lakeville North Panthers 2-1 in overtime. Scores included Megan Wolf and Brooke Mattson with the game winner. Goalie Emma May played an awesome game as well, making 31 saves. This puts the girls with a record of 7-1-2 for the year. Their next game is set for Saturday at home versus Rosemount. On to girls basketball, who had a game on Tuesday versus the Red Wing Wingers and picked up their first win of the season after beating them 82-73. They started out a bit slow, but after captain Jess Hart scored 26 points and Bryn Parsons scored 18, mixed with tremendous second half defense, the game turned around. The Lady Cats are currently 1-2 and ready to pick up another win tonight versus Henry Sibley at home. Make sure you go out and support. The boys wrestling team, which is led this year by seniors Mitch Johnson, Colin Sullivan, and junior Colin Fisher, had their first meet of the season last Thursday night against Lakeville North and came up short 42-34. Then this past weekend, they traveled to Jackson, Minnesota to take part in a 14-team individual tournament and play sixth overall. Luke Keller placed sixth along with Colin Sullivan, Kevin Martinez, and Colin Fisher placing third. Mitch Johnson was the lone champion for the Wildcats as he knocked off their number two wrestler in the 1A finals. They have their next match tonight against the number four team in the nation, Apple Valley. Yes, in the nation. Believe in miracles and pull off that upset, boys. The boys basketball team picked up their first W of the season last Saturday as they beat North St. Paul 73-59. Senior Nick Sabaki was looking like Kobe out there after putting in a stellar 28 points. This puts him at 85 for the season. Shane Manley and Drew Bauer also contributed double digits for the Cats. The guys will be playing for win number two tomorrow versus St. Michael Albertville at home. The boys swim team had their first meet of the year on Saturday against Bloomington Jefferson and did not disappoint, winning the meet 130-55. Egan dominated in almost every race by placing first in the 200 and 400 medley. Senior Andy Knudsen placed first in the 200 free. Eli Broman placed first in the 200 IM and 100 fly. Bill Layton placed first in the 50 and 100 freestyle, and David Street took first in the 500 free, among many others. Their next meet is tomorrow night at home at 6. Good luck, boys, and swim hard. The gymnastics team is ready for another successful season this year, even after losing many seniors last year. This year, it's all about the juniors, which is led by Claire Gutnick, Emily Swenson, Catherine Torres, and Nicole Crookton. They had their first meet on Tuesday versus Lakeville North and lost 126.4 to 136.2. Their next meet is on Tuesday versus Bloomington Jefferson. Best of luck, ladies. The dance team had a competition this past Saturday at the Target Center against Lakeville North. The girls placed first overall in jazz and kick and got the opportunity to perform at halftime during a Timberwolves game this season. Congrats, girls. Varsity Jazz also took home first on their side on Monday night at Apple Valley. Their next meet is the South Suburban Conference Championships on Saturday at Egan. Go out there and cheer them on. Also, congratulations to Eli May for committing to Mankato State next season for hockey. Well, that about wraps it up for you this week on the WCR. Make sure you go out and cheer on all of our successful teams. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Taylor.
That's all we have for you this week, Wildcats.
Remember, the value of the month for December is service, so don't forget to show random acts of kindness.
Stay classy, Egan.